Alors qu'il existe un large consensus
There is a
sur le fait que
broad
la pauvreté
consensus
absolue
on
a
the fact
largement
that absolute
baissé dans le
poverty
pays dans le
has
monde au cours des 30 dernières années, la
receded in
question
the
des
past 30
inégalités
years,
est
but
plus
the issue
discutée.
of inequalities
Elle
is
est
a
apparue
much
que
more disputed
récemment sur le domaine
and
de la
only came
santé.
to the fore
Cette
relatively
partie du
recently.
cours porte sur
This part
l'évolution
of the
des
course will
inégalités depuis le
discuss the
début des années
evolution of
1990.
inequalities since the early
Je
1990s.
commencerai
I
par
shall
rappeler
start by
rapidement pour quelles
reminding you
raisons les
briefly
inégalités sont importantes,
why inequalities are
puis
important.
aborderai la question
Then I
lors
shall
de ce
discuss
webinaire,
their measure.
avant de passer à la présentation
And
de ce que
after
les
that, a
statistiques
presentation
nous
of what
indiquent sur les
statistics
changements
indicate
dans
about
les
changes in
inégalités à
inequalities
l'époque de la mondialisation.
in the age of
La question des
globalization. The
inégalités est
issue
restée
of
longtemps négligée
inequalities
car elles sont
was
apparues à la fois comme
neglected
moteur
largely
et
for a long time
conséquence
because it
inévitable
was
du
seen
développement.
as an unavoidable
Moteur dans
consequence
les
of
travaux d'Arthur
development and also
Lewis
a
et de
driver of
Dr.
development,
Robert Solow.
according to
Chez Lewis, le
Lewis and
développement,
Robert,
c'est
Arthur Lewis and
l'industrialisation
Robert Solow.
qui passe par la transformation
For
des
Lewis,
paysans en
it's
ouvriers.
the transformation of
Comme les
peasants
ouvriers
into
sont plus
workers, and as
productifs
workers are more
grâce à eux, ils sont
productive,
plus élevés,
they have
d'où
higher
un certain niveau
salaries,
d'inégalité,
hence an initial
lequel
level
est
of
utile pour
inequality,
inciter plus
which
de
is useful
paysans
to
à préférer l'industrie.
encourage more peasants to
Dans les
turn
modèles de
towards the industry
croissance,
in
comme
growth
celui de
models,
Lewis de Solow,
such as
les
that
inégalités
of
sont
Robert
utiles.
Solow,
Car
inequalities
l'épargne est
are
nécessaire
useful
pour financer le développement.
because savings are
Or, le taux
necessary to
d'épargne
fund
augmente avec le revenu.
development and savings, the rate of
Il faut
savings
donc des
increases with
inégalités pour
wealth.
accroître. Ces idées sont à
These
l'époque
ideas at the time
portées par
were
l'hypothèse de
supported by
Kuznets, qui, dans les années
Kuznets's
1950,
hypothesis.
avait observé
He
la baisse
observed
des
in the
inégalités
1950s
dans certains
that
pays développés
inequalities
et avait alors supposé qu'il
would drop
suffisait
in
d'attendre
third
que
world
les pays en
countries
développement s'enrichissent
and
suffisamment pour
one
les voir
merely
diminuer.
needed to wait for developing countries to
Il
become
n'y avait donc pas
sufficiently
lieu de s'en
developed
préoccuper,
to see them
d'autant
drop.
plus que les gains des
And in
riches
fact, what
devaient
the
financer
rich
une consommation et un volume
earned
d'investissement qui finirait
would
in fine
serve to fund
par se diffuser à
investments
l'ensemble de la population
and
selon un
it
mécanisme de
would
ruissellement.
trickle down to the rest of the population.
L'hypothèse de Kuznets est connue sous le nom de courbe de Kuznets.
Hypothesis is known
Au cours du processus
under the term
de
of
développement,
Kuznets'
les
curve.
inégalités d'abord
During the
croissent,
development, first there's an increase in inequality, then a stabilization,
et enfin,
and then a reduction.
Mais les travaux réalisés à partir des années
But work
1990
conducted
ont montré que cette courbe
from the 1990s onwards show that this curve does
Il n'y a
not
pas de
exist.
Claire,
There is no clear universal relationship between
et
inequality and development.
Depuis, d'autres travaux
Since,
ont montré que la pauvreté
other work
absolue
has shown that
s'est
absolute poverty,
définie à
that,
partir de la
that
fameuse
what
ligne
is defined,
$1
the
par personne
famous
par jour,
$1 per day
diminue
per
plus ou
person,
moins rapidement lorsque l'économie
decreases more or less quickly when
Certains
the economy
pays sont
grows.
caractérisés
Some
par un
countries
niveau
are characterized
élevé
by a high level of inequality,
La croissance a alors peu d'effet sur la
and in fact,
pauvreté.
Growth has very little effect
Dans les pays où les
on
inégalités
inequality. And in
sont
countries
faibles,
with
la pauvreté
low inequality,
croît beaucoup plus vite.
Poverty
Enfin, on a également
declines
réalisé
much
qu'un
faster,
niveau trop élevé
and
d'inégalité pouvait avoir
a
un
level of
impact
inequality
négatif
that's too
sur la
high can
croissance
have
elle-même
a
parce qu'elle
negative effect
crée des
on
obstacles à l'éducation,
growth because it creates
empêche
obstacles
les
to
pauvres de mener à
education,
bien leurs projets,
prevents the
mine
poor
le
from
développement du marché domestique,
enterprising,
altère le bon fonctionnement de la démocratie
has
et
effects
contribue
on democracy
à l'instabilité politique.
And effects on political
Entre plus,
instability.
Elles réduisent la souveraineté des
It
pays
reduces
pauvres
the sovereignty
et
of poor countries and restricts their ability to defend their own interests. Work in this field is essentially focused on the measure of income inequalities.
Il y a de multiples sources
There are multiple sources of inequality,
education,
health, lifestyle, and so on. But, of course, income is easier to measure and is also relevant because it is the main way by which people can improve their living standards. And there are multiple ways of measuring income inequalities. Basically, they can be categorized into two categories, ratios between income of individuals or countries at the top of the scale and those at the bottom, what we shall start to do in order to examine the change in inequalities from one country to another. There are also composite indicators like the Gini index, inequality across the entire distribution, and we shall use these indicators to measure inequality between individuals. This chart shows the evolution of GDP of three developing countries and the US between 1990 and 2016.
Les valeurs présentées tiennent
the
compte
figures
des
here
de niveau de prix
take
entre
into account the
Burundi,
differences in prices
Vietnam,
from one country
Chine
to another. Burundi, Vietnam, and China in 1990 were among the poorest countries in the world. And the graph shows that they had very different types of evolutions over that time. Inequalities between average living standards in Burundi and the US grew, those between Vietnam and the US, in fact, were much lower. In 1990, the living standard of Burundi was only 2.9% that of the US. But it fell to 1.3% in 2016. The evolution in Vietnam is the reverse of that. And the catch-up of China is quite spectacular, because the average living standards of a person in China in 1990 was 4.1% that of an American, and it's in 2016, it's almost 22%. Let us now see inequalities between individuals, and we're going to use the Gini index that measures the gap in comparison to a situation of perfect equality, 0 and 100 for perfect inequality. It varies between 25 and 65 from one country to another. It's 31 in France and 41 in the US. And the most unequal countries are in Latin America and sub-Saharan Africa. On the individual level, you must also enrich comparison between living standards in various countries and add two important aspects. First, the population, and second, inequality within the countries themselves. The comparison between GDP per person per capita in Burundi and the US was based on the implicit hypothesis that all of the Burundian population, all of the American population, have the same income. But probably some people in Burundi have become very rich and some Americans have become very poor. Individuals become the unit of observation here, which means that every citizen in each country must be placed on the same scale in order to have an overview of global inequality. If you look at this chart here, the first lines show an evolution of the Gini index across all of the world's population. It shows that on the whole, inequalities have not very much changed until the start of the century and then decreased between the year 2000 and the year 2011. And this drop of global inequality also came with an increase of inequalities within individual countries. And the most spectacular evolution is that of China, where the Gini gained more than 10 points between 1988 and 2008, which is considerable. They also increased a lot in sub-Saharan Africa, but dropped in the countries of the former Soviet bloc. So how can one explain the stability, then the decrease in global inequality? At the same time, the living standards in China increased considerably. The average Chinaman was at the bottom of the scale, and now he's in the middle, which largely explains the stagnation of inequalities on the global level. This evolution is represented by this graph by Branko Milanovic. It shows the evolution in percentage points of real incomes between 1988 and 2000. To construct this, the members of the population are categorized in ascending order of income in 1988, then in 2008. There's a calculation of the 5% poorest income and in both years, and the same thing is done for the 5%, the next 5%, and so on, until the top 5%, which is divided into two, the 1% richest, and the 4% under them. You just examine then the evolution in real terms of average incomes, thus calculated between the two dates, and place the result on the graph. So, horizontally, you have the average income in 1988, and vertically, the growth of revenue between 1988 and 2008. Note that 40% of the global population in 1988 had an income of less than $2 a day, and in fact, the great winners of globalization are in the middle of the distribution and at the very top. This translates the dual upward evolution of the income of the Chinese middle class and the top 1% richest in the world. And the poor, who had revenues lower than $2 in 1988, also gained, but less so. And the very poorest gained less than 20% over that period. And those who in 1988 were categorized around the 8th decile, the lower middle classes of developing countries, are largely ignored by these changes. And this graph only gives, of course, a truncated vision, because the investigations and inquiries find it very difficult to measure income at the extremes. And recent work presented on the report on inequalities of the World Inequality Lab, based on tax returns, shows that the rise in the graph here can be taken up to 250% as soon as you reach the maximum wealth in 1988. So globalization has not resulted in an increase of inequality on the global level. When you look at the level of interpersonal inequality rather than what can be observed between the average lifestyle of people, there's in fact a drop of inequalities. But individuals are usually much more concerned by what is going on around them in close proximity, rather than all over the world. And the global evolution, in fact, reflects two evolutions. On the one hand, the rise in living standards in China. Hundreds of thousands of people are being taken towards the middle of the distribution of wealth, which reduces inequalities on the whole, and on the other hand, a considerable increase of inequalities within countries and a concentration of wealth and ownership and property are within a limited number of hands, and stagnation of the living standards of the lower middle classes in developed nations. And these are, of course, true concerns for policymakers, and probably one of the origins of the surprising results of recent votes.